Hi everyone! Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Casey and here on my channel I talk about personal growth, lifestyle, and personal finance. Today I'm going to be doing a flip through of the Clever Fox Budget Planner Pro. So if you're interested in seeing what all this planner has to offer, just keep watching. So to start off, this planner is a hardcover one-year planner that is 7 inches by 10 inches, and it comes in about 5 to 6 color options. I personally have the turquoise color. And this retails for about $25. They sell it on Amazon and you can get it on the Clever Fox website. So let's get started. So the planner comes with an elastic band and a pen loop right here. So to begin with, when you first open up the planner, the first thing you have is your nameplate page. So it allows you to put your name, your phone number, your email, and your reward if someone were to find this. And then we move into our financial goals section. So this first page, it has your financial goals and it has space for 10 goals in total. And then on this side, you have your mind map. So you can use these pages in conjunction with each other and use your mind map to create your financial goals. Then you have your strategy and tactics. So here you have new skills I need to learn to achieve my financial goals, my affirmations for wealth and prosperity, actions I will take to earn more money, and actions I will take to cut my expenses. Then we start off with the monthly view. So there are 12 months in this planner and it's an undated planner. So here I'll zoom in a little bit so you can see exactly what each month looks like. So at the top we have our monthly goals and our to-do list. And then on the top of the other page, we have our upcoming bills and expenses, income and savings. And then on the bottom of the planner, you have an undated calendar. So you can, it's a Sunday start and you can put in your, it has five weeks. And then on this side, there's a notes section. So this is a great dashboard page. And one of the reasons why I wanted this planner is because of the two-page calendar monthly spread. And on here, you can track your bills, your paydays, anything. If you're a visual person like me, I really like being able to see when things are coming out and when things are coming in. So the second page of your monthly spread has your monthly budget on one side and then your monthly budget review. So your monthly budget has 8 different sections, and within each section they're categorized by different types of spending. So we have home, personal, food, entertainment, healthcare, transport, and then at the bottom we have credit and loans and other. So this gives you space where you can, you know, put in what types of expenses you have for each of these categories. And I really like that because some planners have it to where it is already written in there for you, but maybe you don't have those specific expenses. So you're kind of wasting line items. So I love how here you have blank sections for each expense category and you can write in what those expenses are for you personally. Then at the bottom of the page, you have your total budgeted, total actual, and the difference between the two. On the second side, we have our monthly budget review. So at the top, we have our opening balance, total income, total expenses, difference, total savings, and balance forward. So those are great, you know, stats to have every single month. And then this is the thing that really sold me on this planner, is the spending analysis. So I love how it has this pie chart and each of these little sections are 5% each. So at the end of each month, you can go in and categorize, and these are the 8 categories that are on this page. You can go in, put the amount that you spent in each category and the percentage of your total budget that that took up, and then fill in this pie chart to have a visual representation of your budget each month. Then at the bottom of the page, we have my biggest wins this month. Did I achieve this month's goals? If not, why? Did I meet my budget? If not, why? Where did I have the most trouble? What could I improve next month? Actions I will take next month to increase my income. Actions I will take next month to cut my expenses. So there's the second spread in the monthly view. Then we have the expense trackers. So each expense tracker has date, description, category, and amount. And you have 1, 2, 3 of those expense trackers. Now, don't forget, this book is a 7x10 book, so it is a pretty large book. It's like relatively the size of a letter size piece of paper. So I believe that 3 of these pages will be enough for me to fill out all of my expenses per month. And actually, I might use one of these, probably this one, to track my sinking funds. I like to track each paycheck, how much money I put into all of my sinking funds, and then what the amount is at the end of each month. So I'll probably use this third one for that, but you have 3 of those in total. Then here you have your notes and ideas. So here maybe you have specific things that happen each month, or just a great page to have for whatever you need to write down, jot down for that month. And then you move into the next month. Okay, so at the end of the 12-month spreads, we have a savings tracker. So here, I'll zoom in a little on this. So here you have your savings tracker. At the top, you have what you're saving for, the amount you need, and the due date. And then you can track the date, deposit, and total saved of the steps leading up to that goal. And for the savings tracker, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, 8. So you have 2 full spreads of savings trackers with 2 on each page, or 4 on each spread. So we have savings trackers. Then we go into our debt trackers. So similarly, this has the debt name, starting balance, minimum payment, date, amount paid, and balance. So for that, we have 1 spread, 2 spreads, 3 spreads. Okay, so we have 3 spreads of debt trackers with 4 debt trackers on each page. So you have 12 debt trackers. And then we get into our holiday budget. So I really like this. So up here, we have the category slash expense, how much you're budgeting for it, and how much you actually spend. And then you also have a gift list. So you can put in the recipient, what gift that you would like to buy for them, how much you budget that, and how much it actually is. And then you have your actual holiday spending. So where this is more targeted towards holiday gifts for specific people, the holiday spending section doesn't have to be gift focused. It could be, home decor, holiday dinners, and, grocery bills for those types of things. So this is just general holiday spending. And then we move into our regular bill tracker. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, cool. So you have 2 pages of 6 month worth of bill trackers. So you could do January through June, and then July through December. And then here you write the bill that you're gonna track. And then up here you write the months. So this is great for regular bills that you have, such as your rent, your utilities, maybe your gas and electric, your phone, something that you have every single month, but might vary month to month. So this is where you can track that. Then you have your summary of the year. So pretty much this is a large view of the summary of each month page. So let me go back and show you that page. So this here, this monthly budget review page, where it has your categories and how much you spent, you then take all of this information and you can put it in this spread for the entire year. So you can put it has your month, income, savings, home, food, healthcare, credit and loans, personal entertainment and transport, as well as a bunch of other expense, places for you to put your own expenses. And it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months per page. So you have an entire year worth of summary of your year's expenses, income, and savings. So this is great just like as a year end, being able to look back quick at a glance. How did you do this year? How much money did you make? How much money did you save? How much did you spend in each of these categories? So really like this page. And then we go into the doc grid pages. So this planner has 27 pages of doc grid. So, a good amount of doc grid pages. And this is great because I'm someone that likes to use pen in my planner. And before I, set up my actual month here and in this budget page right here, I like to kind of forecast what this will be before I actually write it down in here. So these doctored pages will be great for that. There's 27, so I can do, you know, one for each month, and that's it. The last thing I want to talk about is this planner. It gives you three ribbon bookmarks. So we have one that's like a pink color, one that's yellow, and one that's like a peach color. So those are great. They don't come all the way out to the edge of the planner, so you can't like grab it and pull it and open your book from the complete corner. You still have some good clearance here that you can get it open, but that's that. It does have a pocket in the back, and I do want to show you what comes with this planner other than just the planner itself. So along with the physical planner, you also get some resources to help you fill out your planner and to help you with your budgeting process. So the first thing you get is this little pamphlet on how to use this planner. So it, you know, goes through all the sections. So I really like this one because it helps you use the planner correctly. But then I also like that in this financial goals section, that focus, it has some goals in here that you could use as inspiration for when you're filling out your own planner. So I really like that because where I have some financial goals already in mind, it never hurts to have, you know, some suggestions here. And it also has it here for your strategy and tactics. So some other helpful ideas that you could use when filling out your own planner. So it comes with that. It also comes with a few cash envelopes. So here's what the cash envelopes look like. So here it has a space for you to put the category. Then you have the 12 months of the year, what you budget for this cash envelope, and what you actually spend in this cash envelope. So this is what it looks like when you open it, and it's big enough to where you can tuck in this flap so that your money doesn't fall out of it once you fill it up. So you get five of these. They have navy, this light like baby blue color, a green, kind of like minty green color, lavender, and red. So you get five cash envelopes. You also get your warranty card. If you don't like the planner, you can return it. 60-day money back guarantee, so that's always nice. And then you have three pages of budget stickers. I like how they have this kind of like gold / rose goldy foil on it, so they're really nice stickers. So here's what the planner looks like without the little wrapper thing that I took off. I think it's really nice. It's kind of like a vegan leather cover, so it's really nice. It's not gonna get, you know, dirty. You're able to wipe it off, so I really like that. So here is the Clever Fox Budget Planner Pro, and I will have the link for this in the description below. You can get it on Amazon and on the Clever Fox website. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm super excited to get into this planner and start using it for next year. Let me know down in the comments below if you would be interested in me doing budgeting videos. I love budgeting and I watch budgeting videos a lot, but not sure exactly if I want to actually make them myself. So let me know if you'd be interested in that down below. Before you leave, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!